Hey, Bart here with a quick one today. Let's talk about free energy. Because as with many ideas in science, the name can occasionally result in some real misunderstandings of the concept. I've personally heard the term free energy occasionally be misinterpreted to mean that we can get energy for free from nothing, or in other words, breaking the law of conservation of energy by somehow creating energy out of nothing. The conservation law says that energy is neither created nor destroyed, simply converted from one form to another. So what's going on? Well, the thermodynamic concept of free energy has nothing to do with this. In physics, free energy is just a measure of how much useful energy there is available within a system that we're studying. In other words, it's the amount of energy available to do work rather than to be wasted as heat. For example, let's say the system we're studying is a cricketer about to bowl a ball. If you're not into cricket, then imagine a badminton player or a rock climber. Either way, can you tell what my three favorite sports are at the minute? Anyway, let's imagine our cricketer here. In this case, our system's free energy would be a measure of how much energy is available to be converted into useful work. The store of energy from which it's available is the chemical energy within the bowler's body. And useful work is the energy that gets transferred into the bowler's run-up and eventually actually bowling the ball. The wasted energy is transferred as heat, the heat in the bowler's muscles and the heat that escapes into the ground as the bowler strikes with their foot, and so on. There are some further intricacies to the concept of free energy, such as the processes needing to occur at constant temperature and other constraints depending on what particular kind of free energy we're talking about. All of that has to do with how free energy terms were defined when we first came up with the concept. There are two commonly defined types of free energy, Helmholtz free energy and Gibbs free energy, named after the two scientists that came up with them. Gibbs even initially called his version of free energy available energy, which sounds more like what we're talking about, but we've since changed the name to Gibbs free energy. Very soon on this channel, I'll be uploading a video looking at a few other scientific terms that are easily misinterpreted. If you like this video and want to see more of that, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. Hit the bell button to be notified every time I upload as well. And I wanted to say a huge thanks to all of my Giga patrons and all the others over on my Patreon page. I'll leave a link to that in the description if you'd like to support me on there. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very soon.